Welcome, welcome, welcome everybody. My name is IHateWill, and this is my good friend, Del. How do you know they were the dual-wielding dwarf. Del is El Jefe of this Inquisition. And they prevent wounds from getting infected. Gather as many as you can. The strangest thing. Okay, okay. God, people keep talking. Let me do an intro. This is Del, the dual-wielding dwarf. He is El Jefe. For those of you who do not understand, or hablo the Español, El Jefe means the Jefe. He's in charge of this Inquisition. So he's a bit of a badass. Well, let's read this. Yeah, whatever. Alright. Looks like we got an eyeball over here, so let's see what's doing. Let's take a sit.
Impressive, is it not? Fit for a leader, meant to show influence and the burden of it. It is where the Inquisition will sit in judgment, where you will sit in judgment.
Who will I be judging exactly?
Those who have done wrong. You will know of them, at the very least. All this presumes they have survived their initial encounter with you, of course.
Still more lives in my hands.
You are a beacon of law, Inquisitor, as others retreat from responsibility. But this needn't be bloody. The Inquisition's sovereignty is derived from the allies who validate it. You are both empowered and bound. Justice has many tools. If their application is clever, execution may even seem merciful by comparison.
Well, let's do it.
Is there anyone I should judge?
Take the throne when you're ready. We will bring him before you. You recall Geryon Alexius of Tevinter. Ferelden has given him to us as an acknowledgement of your aid. The formal charges are apostasy, attempted enslavement, and attempted assassination on your own life, no less. Tevinter has disowned and stripped him of his rank. You may judge the former magister as you see fit.
Looks like the turntables have turned, table. These are great charges. The apostasy sticks out. Hey, let's talk about that.
Remind me, what's the precedent for nearly ripping apart time at the seams?
I couldn't save my son. Do you think my fate matters to me?
Will you offer nothing more in your defense?
You've won nothing. The people you saved, the acclaim you've gathered. You'll lose it all in the storm to come. Render your judgment, Inquisitor.
Now, I really want to kill him. Though, imprisoning him could be good too. Or he can be a slave. Let's make him a slave.
You swore to the mages you'd help them. I will have you uphold that promise. Fiona will take charge of you. Any knowledge, favor, or coin you own will go towards the mage's future.
A headsman would have been kinder.
Get out of here, you piece of trash. Yeah, I like power. Let's do some more. Who else? Okay, well, the quarters. Ugh, what a dump. Where's my bedroom, huh? Huh? Is this it? Is this where my bedroom is? Oh, this is nice. I can do this.
Certainly spared no expense.
This is doable. Take. Anything in here? What is this? Oh, graffiti? Oh, God. You people need to grow up. Let's find Dorian. Have not spoken to him. Oh, here he is.
Brilliant, isn't it?
One moment you're trying to restore order in a world gone mad. That should be enough for anyone to handle, yes? Then, out of nowhere, an archdemon appears and kicks you in the head. What? You thought this would be easy? No, I was just hoping you wouldn't crush our village like an anthill. Sorry about that. Archdemons like to crush, you know. Can't be helped. Am I speaking too quickly for you?
You don't need to worry about me. I can keep up.
Yes, I noticed that. Certainly. If you were a slack-jawed yokel, you'd already be dead. I always assumed the elder one behind the Venatori was a magister. But this is something else completely. In Tevinter, they say the Chantry's tales of magisters starting the Blight are just that. Tales. But here we are. One of those very magisters, a darkspawn.
Who does the Imperium say started the Blight?
Okay, it keeps freezing up, so I'm gonna hit skip.
There we go. They say Darkspawn were always there. Magisters and the Blight aren't even related. Is that a surprise? No one wants to admit they shit the bed. But if Corypheus is one of the Magisters who entered the Black City and he's Darkspawn, what other explanation is there?
Why does that make you angry?
Because the Imperium is my home. I knew what I was taught couldn't be the whole truth, but I assumed there had to be a kernel of it somewhere. But no, it was us all along. We destroyed the world.
Last I checked, the Blights hadn't actually destroyed the world.
Not for lack of trying.
Paused again, okay.
No one will thank me, whatever happens. No one will thank you, either. You know that, yes?
They might thank me.
That's not why I'm doing this.
I knew there was something clever about you.
Can we just keep stopping and staring into each other's eyes? Maybe there is something here. We need to pursue it romantically.
Men like him ruined my homeland. I won't stand by and let him ruin the world. Oh, and congratulations on that whole leading the Inquisition thing, by the way.
Strangest thing. When I reached down, my dagger was gone. Just gone. Know where I found it? In a barrel. The thing was filled to the brim with daggers. Got the strangest feeling. I know someone took it right off my belt, but I can't recall who.
Oh, look, it's a Kunari guy. Oh, he's big. All right. Let's open this. And, hey, it's Cullen. Let's talk to him.
Inquisitor, I've found where the Red Templars come from. Therunfall Redoubt. The knights were fed red lyrium until they turned into monsters. Samson took over after their corruption was complete.
How do you know Samson?
He was a Templar in Kirkwall, until he was expelled from the Order. I knew he was an addict, but this... Red lyrium is nothing like the lyrium given by the Chantry. Its power comes with a terrible madness.
Samson's armor was glowing with this stuff. He'll go mad soon enough.
He seemed clear-eyed at Haven. Even so, the deluded commander is no less worrisome. The Red Templars still require lyrium. If we find their source, we can weaken them and their leader.
I like finding the Red Templars' vulnerabilities before fighting them head-on.
We'll need every advantage against what courses through their veins. Caravans of red lyrium are being smuggled along trade roads. Investigating them could lead to where it's being mined. If you confront them, be wary. Anything connected to Samson will be well guarded.
Okay. Let's jump off and go to the war room. Oh, your little ankle, buddy.
I've heard rumors of abandoned warden camps all over these parts. If we have time, I'd like to take a look, see if there's anything we can salvage.
Barrick's friend Hawk said there were suspicions of corruption in Grape.
Corruption?
Corypheus. He's been known to influence.
That could very well explain why so many have disappeared.
If this is true, then all wardens are in danger. Even you.
I agree. If Hawk's given you an idea where to start, we should get moving immediately.
Nothing right.
And what else did Lady Forsythia say? That she'd rather drown herself than help the Inquisition. Anything else? She said she'd have us flogged alive if we allied with her brother. That does sound like her. Cheer up, Josie. We at least have her attention. You always do find the brighter side of things. We are in the midst of cementing an alliance with Lady Forsythia of Nevara, Your Worship. It's become a somewhat delicate task.
Can I do anything to help negotiations?
Thank you, but I believe I have matters in hand. I dissuaded her from sending soldiers when she learned we'd struck an accord with a brother she's feuding with. Lady Forsythia simply employs a colorful manner of speech.
Dealing with so many demanding, strong-willed people can't be easy.
It's no less intense than my days at court, Inquisitor, I assure you. But I confess I do miss my staff from the embassy in Antiva. It was always useful to discuss the day's visitors with them.
I have time, if you'd like to review things with me.
I wouldn't wish to impose.
If it were imposing, I wouldn't have offered.
Well, I admit, there are a few potential alliances it would be good to discuss.
All right.
Right on the parlor floor. In front of everyone at the soiree. Who does such a thing in front of their guests?
The Duke of Kellington, apparently.
And then there's Cole's lurking. It frightens our guests half to death. Lord Jenner still won't respond to our letters. And Sarah, can she not find a single overshirt with that mustard taint on it? Then there's Dorian. The man refuses to take anything seriously unless it suits its whim. Not to mention... Oh, goodness. Have we been here an hour already?
Okay.
It went by so quickly, I didn't even notice.
You're far too polite. I didn't intend to go on for so long. You must think me quite the gossip.
Let's do a little flirt action. I mean, I don't like gossips. But, you know what? I'm not getting any play from anybody else, so... Yeah.
Spending time with such an engaging woman is never unpleasant, Lady Montpellier.
Goodness. I'm glad I haven't wasted your day. Well, I've taken up quite enough of your time already. Until next time, Your Worship.
Mm-hmm. I think she blushed a little bit. Okay, let's see if she'll talk to me one more time. Oh, where is she? These ravens, crows, these blackbirds, ominous as hell. Hey, girlfriend. We're girlfriends now.
Inquisitor, is it true? Is the mark on your hand magic cast by Corypheus?
Corypheus claimed it's a spell gone wrong.
I wanted to think it was a blessing. A sign the Maker was returning to his creation. How credulous of me.
Perhaps the Maker set these events in motion so long ago we can no longer see his hand in them.
It would be fitting if that were true. Does it hurt? The anchor, that is.
It's not pain. It's more like my nerves go on fire.
It sounds most unpleasant. A situation requires your attention, Inquisitor. Noble Chantry loyalists in the city of Jader are spreading accusations that you're responsible for the Divine's death. They're unusually organized. I recommend we send people to Jader to deal with the matter.
Will anyone even believe me if I claim I didn't kill the Divine?
Perhaps if they learn about your heroics. We should emphasize how you stopped the breach devouring the sky. Even in Jader, it may win you a few admirers.
What does the nobility gain by saying I murdered Justinia?
A scapegoat, to begin with. But I wonder if the grand clerics are at work. Those immediately eligible to be divine died at the conclave. The ones remaining were not as favored. They may look upon you as a rival for influence.
Let's send some diplomats.
Let's send some ambassadors to convince Jader I'm not a monster in disguise.
Excellent. I believe there's much to be gained by winning them over.
You gonna talk to me again?
A pleasure.
Oh, I already know this. Well, that's gonna do it for today's episode, everybody. We stood in judgment of a douchebag, and we may have started a romance with a certain Orlesian diplomat. But for now, this is Will. I am signing off. Take care of yourself, and I will see you the next time.